Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to CBW When the Walls Fall. My name is Mags, and tonight we have an action-packed show for you, starting off with the CBW owner, Captain Law, taking on the general manager, Iconic, Chase Sullivan. So let's throw it down to the table and get this show underway.
And ladies and gentlemen, we are here tonight at When the Walls Fall after that beautiful entrance. Obviously, you know, this wasn't the original match. We originally were supposed to have Law versus Steel in a last man standing contest. But now we've got Law versus the general manager, Chase Sullivan. I'm joined on commentary here tonight by the one, the only Fallen Star, Pepsi Drink, and Fourth Wall Break, and all that good stuff, Riley Bates.
Well, hello, ladies and gentlemen, here is the man they call Captain Law.
And his opponent.
Indeed, Law looking a little worse for wear, not really coming out wearing any kind of gear today. I wonder if he's taking Chase lightly tonight.
You never know. You know, I have never seen Mr. Chase Sullivan ever wrestle before, but I'd assume he's probably got something up his sleeve. Or I should say, no, something up his glove.
Now, obviously, you may not have ever seen it, but we here at the Infinity Arena have seen Chase compete before. He is the current UWA Underground Champion. So that.
Check his lats. Literally, bend him over. Check his booty hole.
Law being a little vulgar here tonight.
The hell? So check his booty hole. What the hell kind of ship is going on here? I didn't sign up to be expecting someone's booty hole.
Law having a little fun with Chase. He's taking Chase lightly here tonight. That may not pose that well for him, Riley.
Yeah. Oh, look at this. I wonder if we're going to get this match started. These two are running at each other. Let's just get this match started, man. I want to see these two go at it. Two big bulls. I want to see them go at it, man.
And the bell's been rung. Referee Ash, the the official for this match. Chase throwing the gloves at Law.
These two circling. We're circling now. Let's see what's going to... Oh, what the... Captain Law just wiping his ass with that glove. I don't think that's sanitary for that ring, but nevertheless, we're getting this going in. Oh! What a clothesline there.
Not able to knock the big man down, though. Too deep. Getting a little extra momentum with the discus, and down goes Law.
Good Lord, what a forearm. I wonder if Mr. Captain Law is now regretting not wearing any gear, not preparing for this match, or anything of that sort.
I feel like he's taking Chase too lightly tonight. We know Chase can go. In fact, these two have faced each other before at the Nova Tribute Show over on the BYWN channel for the Anarchy Championship in what was one hell of a grueling contest.
Yeah.
And now Law out of the ring.
It's like Chase is in some pretty deep trouble. Captain Law grabbing that traffic cone.
A traffic cone is not a soft object landed in between the legs.
Oh, this is going to be really difficult. Oh! Ooh, I feel bad for Mr. Sullivan there. That's probably going to leave a mark or two in the little testicle region right there.
Right in the McGiblets. Law has firmly taken this match back in control.
Do we want more of you walking around?
I think Captain Law is talking way too much. If I were him, if I was Captain Law in this scenario, I wouldn't be talking all this trash. I'd be trying to get this match done and over with as soon as possible. I would take chance, throw him in the corners, you know, a couple times, give him a couple of chops right in the chest, maybe down there below where he was targeting that traffic cone. Who knows? And, you know, just end this match early. Hit him with the finisher, and 1, 2, 3, getting this done and over with.
Oh, well, speaking of taking him lightly, Chase able to get control. He's got that bull rope around the neck of Captain Law.
Could be seeing some, some dusty roads here with that bull rope. All we need is some more cowbell. You know what I'm saying.
Indeed, and he's choking him with that rope over top of the other rope, kind of hanging him a little bit there. That's not the first time Law has felt that either.
And probably won't be the last time here in this match.
Sullivan has firmly taken the control back, now trying to goad Captain Law back up to his feet.
What is Chance looking for here?
Law staggering back into the corner. And a huge splash.
Oh.
Sullivan going for the third, trying to put it away here. Law breaks out of it.
What a reversal. Oh! What a boot. Now a DDT planting Chase right on his head. Listen, did you notice how the ring shifted? These two are two big bulls going at it here tonight. The one in opening match, that was a close two count there for Mr. Captain Law. But like I said, notice how the ring is shifting. You can't get any more of a spectacular match than this. And I don't know what the hell. Oh, that's McDonald's fries. You know what? That looks yummy right now. I think I might order some McDonald's fries for the show. Because let me tell you, this is going to be an amazing show. What an opener here tonight. But as I'm saying, like I said, the ring was shifting when these two were moving. That's how you know this is a once-in-a-lifetime match. And I don't know what's going on with the flies here, but oh, what a kick right to the back.
Sullivan handing that fan back his prize, but that fan caused the distraction, and Law able to take over with a running knee to the back of Sullivan while Sullivan was draped over the ropes.
What next?
One.
Captain Law,
two. Hey, what's that over there? Put a headlock on.
Trying to distract the referee to make sure the ref can't count. Referee doing a fine job here tonight of counting, and Law's got that pipe.
Pipes can be used for many different ways. Let's match it all right off the back of Chance, but I think what Captain Law, good Lord. I'm at a loss of words, man. Takeover. I don't know what I just saw.
He shoved the brown pipe in Sullivan's brown pipes. It.
Wow, that is
ladies and gentlemen.
This match is getting all over the place. And a cross face, some actual wrestling here. A cross face by Captain Law to Chance Sullivan.
One of the signature submissions of Law. Now Law going for that leg lock, that laid out half crab, but Sullivan gets to the ropes.
But if this is no holds barred, there should be no rope breaks here.
If I remember hearing Law correctly, he said it was UAW rules. So I think this no holds barred was my bad. And in UAW rules, there are rope breaks as well as countouts. There's just not disqualifications.
Ah, I see.
Sullivan out the pipe of his own. He can't see. Oh! Sullivan gets himself with the pipe.
What a Kyle O'Reilly moment right there. Two, and a kick out at two. Man, there's no holds barred match.
Law gagging himself by the smell of that pipe. I would probably be gagging too if I've been where that pipe has been.
I don't think no one's been where that pipe has been. No. I think Captain Law is, you know, just taking his sweet old time in this match. And I also think that Mr. Chance Sullivan is doing the same thing. They're taking their time with this match. Even though this is no holds barred, or UAW rules, no holds barred, whatever. This match is pretty damn cool. I think what they should do is just try and end it early. You know, inflict as much pain as you need to on one part of the body. And if I was Chance, I'll be honest, I think what I should do is actually go after the leg. I don't know why he's using this pipe right against the gut of Captain Law, but I think you should go after the legs. If you go after the legs, the man can't stand.
Oh, he's giving Law a taste of his own medicine with the pipe.
I don't think that was pointing near the ass there, my guy. I think that was, a little bit in front of the ass there.
A little bit of the gooch.
Yeah.
Law saying it was shades of prison all over again.
I don't think Captain Law's been in the prison, man. What is Chance going for here? Is this a choke here?
That pebble fell from the sky. That rock fell from the sky. And Law used that loaded fist. If you smell, just throws the rock out of the ring. This match has been off the rails here tonight.
I'll say it's been all over the place, my guy. Let me tell you.
Bro, now Law having Ash check the turnbuckle bit, and a double low blow. They both caught each other.
Talk about the right place and right time.
Law with a well-placed kick and Sullivan with a well-placed forearm right to the inside of the groin area. Both of these men are down trying to get back up now, trading shots.
Look at these heavy blows by both men.
Law with the forearms, Chase with the forearm back. These two are trading shots. Both big men have a lot of power behind those forearm strikes. And Sullivan getting the upper hand. Could be looking to set up for the infringement. That set out lariat.
Oh my lord. I've never seen a big man throw a super kick like that.
Law calls that the super thick super kick. And could be looking for a bit of the drift away. I don't know if he's going to be able to get it on Sullivan. Sullivan was too big. I don't think Law got all of that.
I would agree with you there. I don't think he got all of it, but he did hit it. What a drift away by Mr. Captain Law. Goes for the pin now. One, two, and oh, look. What luck there by Mr. Chance Sullivan. Good ring awareness, grabbing the ropes. What a match.
Sullivan with that veteran ring awareness, and haven't seen him much in the ring, but he's apparently been paying attention.
Yeah.
Now Law back to his feet and a kick to the ass. And now laying those big legs and knees into the back. But Sullivan trying to take back over here. Has Law staggered. What's Sullivan going for here?
Oh, what a clothesline.
I don't think Sullivan's done with him, though. That looks like it could have knocked Law out.
I think it did knock Law out, but, you know, I don't think this is what Chance wants here.
Sullivan now picking up Law.
What is Chance looking for here?
I think Chase is looking to put it away here. The infringement!
What a lariat.
And the ref's slow to get into position. But that's it, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh my God.
Sullivan has beaten the owner.
What a match.
I don't know what to call that. I don't know if anybody's ever going to rate that match 5 stars, but it was certainly one off-the-wall contest here at When the Walls Fall.
Let me tell you, I think Captain Law's ego as a wall just fell down.
Last time it was all good. It's all good, bro.
All good?
It's all good.
Okay, well, good.
There's your belt.
Alright.
Here's your belt.
Oh my God!
Oh my God! Two count!
I tried, sorry.
And an interesting turn of events. JLS able to retain the 24/7 championship. But will that title retention streak continue? And will Kurt Adams be able to retain? Let's find out.
Ladies and gentlemen, there he is, the real CBW Unified United States Champion. Obviously doesn't have the belt due to somebody's thievery.
Listen, man, I didn't do anything. All I did was pin Mr. Kurt Adams, and that was it. I'll be completely honest, I don't even remember what happened after I won.
Well, what happened after you won was, despite it not being a title match, you walked out with the championship in your hands. And we found out that that was because Mr. Kurt Adams' opponent here tonight, GM Phoenix from BWF, paid you to walk away with that title.
Well, I'll be 100% honest with you people, because I know I never lie. I had nothing to do with GM Phoenix nor the loss. And my only goal was to beat Kurt Adams, even if it was not for that title that this man has in his hands.
You see GM Phoenix walking out with the championship again. He is not the United States champion. That a man is a thief.
It's not yours.
You could feel the animosity in this arena here tonight in between these two. You could cut it with a knife, but it still wouldn't stop the animosity between GM Phoenix and Brett Adams.
Do you
want
to go right now?
Yeah, I do want
to
do this right now.
No, it's my fucking belt.
No, it's my belt. I own it now, you little bitch. Hey, yeah. Hey, look at me when I'm insulted.
GM slapping Kurt Adams
belt.
Here and now.
You're never going to get it back.
Your fucking belt.
These two are going to go
back.
Fair and square. You're just going to think you're going to pay someone off and
right
take it from me, huh?
To facing
I do.
Each other
yeah.
Head to head
you know
here.
Why? Because it works.
Why
the loss
work,
is better huh? than you. And
the
you're
loss?
Never going to take down the loss because the loss doesn't lose to little bitches like you.
Oh. When this match started right away, Kurt Adams dropping GM Phoenix with some straight rights, right to straight lefts, right to the side of the face, and now Kurt is gonna look for a snap suplex right to GM Phoenix, but he's gonna keep it on.
Slam you in the ground.
And he's gonna go for another one here, and still gonna go on. Could he be looking for the Three Amigos here, ladies and gentlemen?
Oh no!
And he did. Three Amigos by Kurt Adams to GM Phoenix. Now going to go for the pin. 1-2 and a kick out at 2.
That Third Amigo kind of looking like a brain buster here tonight. Now GM Phoenix looking to take over, but Adams able to stop it.
Oh, what a overhand chop by GM Phoenix and Kurt Adams. These two just going at each other. They don't care about a wrestling match. This is a brawl here, ladies and gentlemen.
These two so similar in their moves. How they move in the ring and how they act. Throwing Adams into that pit.
That's right.
You gotta know that's gotta hurt Kurt Adams here, even though this is a normal match.
And you're just the original loser.
You gotta know that that's gotta hurt Kurt Adams right there.
Come on.
Back first. Now, you see, I've been in this arena here. I know this arena left, right, like the back of my hand. But you see, the thing is there's so many ways that this arena can be used against your odds, against your favor. And that fence right there is one of them. As I say, Kurt Adams with an elbow right to the side of the face of GM Phoenix. And now could he be looking for, a back fist. He almost ended me with that back fist that Kurt Adams was going to go for here. Now GM Phoenix with the offense here.
Adams looked to roll GM Phoenix up, but Phoenix was able to kick out. Drop toe hold down, go. Adams, another pinfall. Again, kicking out.
Come on.
Now, what a big, what a kick by GM Phoenix to Kurt Adams, now laughing at him. Oh my lord!
These two not pulling any punches here tonight.
No, they're not. You see, one thing I can tell about Kurt Adams here is as GM Phoenix delivers another big right to the side of the skull of Kurt Adams. As I was saying, what I know about Kurt Adams here is he's never going to give up just like that. And now, these two blocking shots, and now, GM with a roll up here, only at a 2 count. And now, a big kick. I was just going to say, Kurt Adams never gives up. And Kurt Adams is relentless when it comes to attacks, when it comes to matches, comes to moves, because he knows how to chop down a body. He knows how to, he knows every which way to pull mind games, verbal games, hell, even physical games on a human body. I know from firsthand experience. But it looks like Kurt Adams is receiving the same treatment he gives to every single person in the locker room in the back right here tonight. And a big
I would dare say that is just a mockery of Kurt Adams.
I would agree with you there. Look at this technical wrestling here from both men. And now, ducking each other's moves, and going for a super kick by Kurt. GM catching the leg, and now gonna go for an ankle lock here.
How do you like that?
I hate to say this, because I don't want to say it, but it looked like a girl version of an ankle lock. And now I'm gonna go for, go for a Boston Crab here. Yeah, there he is. I was just gonna say, all he has to do is sink it in for a Boston Crab, and he just done that.
Adam's struggling to get to the ropes here.
Adam's using his will, trying to will his way to the ropes here.
Come on.
And when the wall fall, but Adam's don't want his wall falling over. Tell you that. Finally gets the ropes.
One, two.
GM Phoenix breaking that hold. GM Phoenix has had Kurt Adams' number almost this entire match.
I would agree with that statement here. Now, looks like a backbreaker almost?
Whatever it was effective.
It really was.
You're done now.
Goes for the pin one. Here. One. Oh, two. One, two. Oh, two. Good lord. Slow counts here tonight at When the Walls Fall.
Damn it.
Adams was barely able to kick out of that.
He was. I'm wondering if this could be it right here. Whatever GM Phoenix is looking for, this could be it right here. Oh, this picks up Kurt Adams. Kurt Adams with some strikes and now a big jawbreaker. And now, a code breaker right to GM Phoenix.
That system has been broken, ladies and gentlemen. Here tonight at Win the Wall.
Kurt Adams has to have the strength to pin GM Phoenix here tonight.
One.
Will he? And he does.
Two.
GM Phoenix barely pulling enough strength to kick out of that.
Son of a bitch.
Now these two trading blows. Back and forth.
Slowly but surely they are. Not pulling any punches. Oh, Kurt blocks it. And a big, big left hand. And now again. Now Kurt unleashing his anger all over GM Phoenix. And now a big clothesline dropping Phoenix down. As Kurt Adams is wanting Phoenix to come right at him again and another clothesline. Now what could Kurt Adams be looking for? A big super kick right in the side of the jaw. I saw some spit coming flying out of the mouth of GM Phoenix. And oh my lord, what a drop kick right to the side of the face or the temple of Kurt Adams. It looked like it didn't get him, but let me tell you, I saw a foot hit the top of Kurt Adams' forehead there. It caught him as much as anyone wants to say. GM Phoenix releasing some big right hands right to the side of the skull of Kurt Adams.
These two tearing each other down here tonight.
And again, some big moves here. Moves that you wouldn't expect to see out of GM Phoenix.
A beautiful combination resulting in the coffin drop.
You're done.
From GM Phoenix there.
One here.
Two.
Two. A big kick out of two. Kurt Adams.
Two and three.
Come on.
Kurt looking for here. And now a double clothesline, both of each other going down. You know what? Who do you have coming out of this match?
Honestly, it seems like GM Phoenix has had Kurt Adams' number this entire contest, right?
I would agree with that statement. As Kurt Adams throwing his shoulder right into the midsection, you know that's going to target the liver, that's going to target the abdomen, that's going to target his rib cage. You know, everything wrong with the gut will happen when you get hit with a shoulder block like what Kurt Adams is doing just then. And now a big splash by Kurt going into a big bulldog. Face planting and a big elbow drop right to the lower spine. I've got to crack some vertebrae. There we go. Vertebrae.
And let's not forget the fact that GM Phoenix did that to Kurt earlier in the match. Again, and a beautiful backstabber.
My lord. GM Phoenix pulling out some big moves here to try and end Kurt Adams here.
GM Phoenix has been giving Kurt Adams almost everything Adams has been giving Phoenix verbatim this entire contract.
You know, I would like to say this. I'd like to say this with all due respect. Professionally, I respect Kurt Adams and GM Phoenix. Personally, I don't like Kurt Adams, but professionally, I say that this man is probably the best in the game.
Whoa.
Yes. People.
I beat Kurt Adams.
GM
That's
Phoenix
right.
just
you.
Beat.
I beat you.
Kurt
it's
Adams,
all your, wait.
But guys in the back, I think me and this commentator here, we saw something.
That looked like the foot was on the rope.
I'm the champion.
I genuinely don't think that Phoenix won this match, but I genuinely think we might need a replay on this, ladies and gentlemen.
I agree with that statement there. I think we need a replay. You know, hey, I'm trying to check in with the guys in the back. You know, hey, can we get a replay on this right now? Can we see that?
Monkey's in the truck. Replay the film. Here we go. Instant replay. The foot is on the rope.
Yeah.
Phoenix, you might want to turn around and finish this match, man.
Because
the bell never rang. This match is not over.
You know what I think?
GM Phoenix throwing
down
that belt. That was a beautiful belt.
Suck my
throwing it around. Look at this. Oh, Kurt Adams. With a big move, dropping. GM Phoenix rolling back. Let's see. Well, could Kurt Adams pull an upset here and beat the champion?
It's time to end this.
There's no beating the champion. Adams is the champion, Riley. We know you may have some feelings about that, but he is the champion.
One.
Ladies and gentlemen, comes
three,
two, three. Ladies and gentlemen, Kurt Adams won the match. And is still, I guess, is still the champion.
Here's
your winner and rightful UAW
rightful champion,
United States champion, the sexy bearded cop, the backbone of the backyard.
I disagree with that statement there, backbone of the backyard. I disagree with that statement, but congratulations, Kurt Adams, on winning this match.
I know. It's really sad that the only relevant person in CBW is not competing tonight in a CBW pay-per-view. See, due to some unfortunate circumstances that are none of your goddamn business, I will not be competing against El Gordo here tonight at When the Walls Fall. And it's pretty funny how I was promised a title match. Now I was supposed to defend it tonight. I'm not gonna do that bullshit. I bet if I was Kurt Adams, I wouldn't have to, but that's a different conversation for a different time. Just know, Jason X and CJ, whether it's a Destiny rematch from UWA or a first time ever match, the headline is watching closely. And either way, I will be a 13-time Backyard Wrestling World Heavyweight Champion. See one of you bitches soon.
Amazing title defense by Kurt Adams, and we heard Aaron Blaze stake his claim for the next show for his Critical Championship match. Will he be facing CJ or will he be facing Jason X? Let's find out.
The following contest is your Win the Walls Fall main event. And it is a one-on-one contest for the Critical Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first, the challenger.
And ladies and gentlemen, main event time. As you see on the screen, the Titantrons are playing. And this, the word obey and the Bad Wolf song can only mean one thing here tonight. I mean, the presence of the one and only CJ.
Mags, this main event time. I cannot wait for this match to happen. CJ, I've heard many good things about him, many bad things about him, but overall, as a wrestler, I think that he is one of the best talents in the BYW game. Period.
Indeed, this man has done so much in just a short amount of time, and here he is, folks, repping the same attire he did at UWA Final Destination. Black and white. For without the dark, there is no light. For without the light, there is no dark.
that's a little philosophical, don't you think? Without the light, there is no dark. Without the dark, there is no light. I mean, it makes sense, but a little philosophical for my personal taste. But not more or less. Here he is in the ring.
And the entrance of his opponent, ladies and gentlemen. That, for lack of a better term, heavy riff on the guitar can only mean the presence of one individual. You see the shining through the mask. Your critical heavyweight champion, ladies and gentlemen, Jason X, is here.
Ladies and gentlemen, the man looks like he just got done fighting Freddy Krueger. But he is your critical heavyweight champion. And I am stoked to see what's going to happen in this matchup right here. Two
and
big competitors coming in this match. Going to give it the Raw. Now, is this for the title?
Indeed it is. It is a critical heavyweight championship match. CJ last show was facing El Luchador Gordo in a vacant championship match when all of a sudden Jason X's music hit. Jason X came out and cashed in the Showdown briefcase mid-match to capture the Critical Heavyweight Championship, pinning Gordo in the process, which is why CJ was granted a rematch.
I see. And now it looks like this referee's gonna want the belt, and we're gonna get this match started as both competitors will look at the title.
Honorable official Santiago prying the title from the grasp of Jason X.
CJ looks calm and collected here, folks. I wonder if he has a plan going on, or if he's just always like this. Is he always like this?
He for the most part always has a level head about him. But we've seen him able to tap into that aggression when he faced Jake Powell, one of our commentators, at UWA Final Destination, where he would go on to lose the UWA Heavyweight Championship to Jake Howell.
I see. Three patting down both men. I'm just eager to get this match started, man. Just ring the bell. Don't care about patting anyone down. Ring the bell, man.
Ring the bell.
And the bell has been rung, and these two are going to go at it head-to-head here tonight in the main event.
Indeed. And you mentioned Freddy Krueger. Funny you should mention that, because Jason's tag team partner is actually Frederick Von Krueger. And you gotta in the Friday Night Nightmares. And you gotta wonder if maybe Frederick will pop up and help Jason here tonight.
Never, ever, no.
Swearing up, lockup, CJ getting control, headlock takeover.
Some technical wrestling here, folks. You've got it. CJ with a big headlock. Now going to go for a head leg scissors to CJ. Does Jason has some grip applied to them big thighs right there. Now CJ powering out of it, grabbing the leg.
Dropping the knees right onto the leg.
Good. Right onto the thigh, it seemed like.
Jason X hasn't really been able to garner any momentum since the bell rang. It's been all CJ this entire time.
Well, if Jason X is just like how the movies predict, you know, he'll always come back and he'll be stronger and faster and more intelligent than ever.
Indeed, intelligent. Minding the fact that CJ didn't trap the arms at all, he was able to rake the forehead and eyes of CJ. Now stomping on the legs, obviously CJ wouldn't be able to stand up and hit the K&K if he doesn't have legs to stand up.
Wait, did you just say KK?
K&K.
Oh, I thought you said KK, man. If he would have hit that, and we could have had a problem there, ladies and gentlemen. Houston, we could have had a problem, but we avoided it there. And oh, a big, big kick. Big super kick right to the side of the face of Jason X to CJ.
DJ, being a former world champion, knows what it takes to conquer in a main event. Jason X has never held the world championship before. This is his first experience. So you gotta wonder if maybe that main event pressure will get to him here.
CJ being a little cocky here. He's letting Jason X up. If I were CJ, I'd just go right at him. You know, of course I'd let him catch his breath, you know, a little bit like that, but I'd go right after him. If I were CJ, if I were anybody in the main event, if I were anyone on this show, first thing I'd do, go after the legs. The man can't stand. Me being a smaller opponent than anyone else, go after the legs. If the guy can't stand, or if your competitors can't stand, they have no chance of beating you. And
again, more technical wrestling
are pretty tall, pretty strong, and very good wrestlers. I'd say go after the legs, my guys. Do what you need to do. Go after the legs. They can't stand, and you have a better chance of beating a grounded opponent than you do a standing tall one.
CJ standing at 6'3", definitely a tall oak tree here tonight. Jason X not as tall, stands at about 5'8", 5'9", in that area. So CJ definitely has the height advantage. Trying to get back to keep talking some smack about Jason's mother.
See, Jason with a big punch, and again, and CJ just eating him. Yeah, phasing him, and CJ with a big right hand. Jason's mask could have fallen off, and we could have seen the ugly mug that's underneath that mask like every single Friday the 13th movie, and now CJ, with a big knee!
Running knee strike, almost shades of the K&K, but was not quite. And now with an arm lock, wrenching on the shoulder blade area of Jason X. Obviously, Jason X unable to hit Sister Abigail if he doesn't have a working arm. That Sister Abigail movie calls him Machete.
Oh, what a big, looked like an uppercut there. A stomp and a mud hole on CJ.
These two are putting in the strikes on one another. CJ rolls out of the ring. Smart ring presence from the challenger here tonight.
Indeed.
But if he wants to win that title, he's got to get back in the ring, because as we know, the titles cannot change hands on pinfalls or submission.
This referee, I don't know. This referee seems a little bit. Look out there. You can see CJ grabbing his knee. Looks like he may be injured here, folks. The referee might have to put up the X sign here. And look at this. Jason X grabbing the head, trying to smush it into like a raisin.
Startling the referee now, wrenching the arm against the ropes here. This ref's got to get Jason off of him. CJ is literally on the ropes. I'm not sure this referee knows what he's doing. We gotta stop hiring these Craigslist referees.
Yeah, stop hiring mass officials, to be completely honest with you. I mean, some of them do all right, but the other ones, you know, you never know what their background is. You never know if they're, you know, just out here for a dollar or out here for the actual sport event itself.
Well, Santiago is a seasoned official here. He actually officiated the match where Jason X cashed in and cost CJ the title. Now CJ taking Jason X down, barely though, trying to get back to his feet.
Gotta wonder if that's the knee that CJ was having some issues with. You know, looks like it is. On the outside.
CJ has a running history of knee problems. So it's smart of Jason X to target it.
It would. And that's what that it goes back to what I was saying earlier in this match. What a big kick. What a big bicycle kick right there to Jason X. And that's what I was saying earlier, folks. If you target someone's leg, they won't be able to stand. And if Jason X has an opportunity here, even though he just got kicked right in the face, he has an opportunity here to go after CJ.
Three.
You have to keep targeting that knee, keep targeting that leg, whatever it may be. You will have a ground CJ, and he can't hit his knee. He can't do anything. Now these two just staring at each other. And oh, CJ with a big knee.
Beautiful maneuver there, popping up. Getting up. He might have been playing possum with that knee this entire time.
Here, Max, he might be playing possum here, and he might just be fooling all of us.
We know CJ loves to play mind games. Look at over in UWA with the whole DL situation and the mafia. Oh, breaking the fingers of Jason X.
Someone watch out in the crowd. There may be kids watching, CJ. Come on now.
Hide your wives and hide your kids, ladies and gentlemen.
Every man for himself.
Are you okay?
I should say every finger for itself. CJ delivers some blows right to the back, and now Jason X just standing up and a big kick right to the side of the face. And Jason X ain't having any of it. No, some big right hands and some chops. And oh, a big bell clap right to the side of the face. CJ and a big kick right to the back of the neck. And now Jason X mask fell off. CJ could have
get a replay of that kick right there. That kick could have put CJ away permanent. That was right to the back of the neck.
We could have seen him paralyze CJ here. I think that's what Jason X wants. But you would hate to see that if it happened.
Indeed. CJ, a great competitor, would hate to see him. Oh! Machete!
Oh my lord! What a move!
That could be it right there. Beautiful machete.
Two, and oh, a kick out at two. Just barely CJ powering out of it.
No. I believe that's the first time anyone has ever kicked out of a machete.
If
maybe
so,
the second time. The first time in history was a
match we are seeing here tonight.
Indeed, this match won for the history of the only other person to ever kick out of a machete.
We're both down. One. Yeah!
Jason X has to be wondering, what does he have to do?
Everybody do us all a favor, go down
here. CJ now struggling to get up. Leans on the corner here, using the ropes to get up here. Now, oh, a big uppercut. Now, a big discus forearm dropping both men. I think that CJ used every amount of effort he had left in his body to deliver those two maneuvers. And then again, look at this. He's either playing possum or his knee is actually having some real problems with it. The referee may have to go check on Mr. CJ here.
I think he tweaked the knee on that discus forearm. I don't know, though, but we know CJ likes to play possum. It's going to be all
CJ just talking some smack right here to Jason X tonight. You know, Jason X cranking the neck.
A single goddamn soul.
And now, oh, a big splash by Jason X, and now delivering some blows, and now shaking the head, maybe? I don't know. Pulling on the hair, and some more chops and some more blows by Jason X to CJ here. Now, oh, giving CJ a snake bite or something along those lines. And now CJ with a maneuver dropping Jason X. I couldn't see what it was.
It looked like a rolling chop block.
Never seen one of those in my career here in BYW, but I guess tonight is a first for many things.
Innovative offense, ladies and gentlemen, got the job done. CJ is up and Jason's down. This could be it. CJ could be looking to set up for that K&K out of the corner.
he hits it, Jason X could be done and over with here tonight.
Tell him he's going to take that world title. He's setting up for stomps and he K&K!
Lord, what a knee. Someone call an EMT because Jason X's head went.
That's Dark Skull's music.
Oh my lord.
Where's he at? What is Dark Skull doing here?
Ladies and gentlemen, get Dark Skull coming. We're in this match. Oh, look at Jason X in the ring. One, two, three, ladies and gentlemen. Jason X with the roll up here and is still your critical heavyweight champion.
I don't know. I guess that means Jason X is going to be facing Aaron Blaze next.
Well, all right. Mr. Aaron Blaze, good luck in future endeavors. I don't know how anyone is going to stop the role of Jason X, but can we just talk about the fact that Dark School's music was playing as a distraction almost?
Does that mean Dark Skull's going to be working with the Friday Night Nightmares, or does he have a bone to pick with CJ?
Every little fucking boyfriend come
out
here
next time on this programming.
Hey, bitch! You forgot something. You got your prize, fuckface. Bullshit. Ever since I've been here, I've been screwed over.
Ladies and gentlemen, we thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time.